very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our science session. So in last period we have started our new lesson, that is sorting materials into group. In this we have already discussed some point, we have discussed about the object, also we have discussed about what is mean by classification of an object, and also we have discussed about why the classification of an object is important, that is what importance of classification. So today in this video we will move for the next point, that is materials. Okay, what is mean by materials? Let's see. A substance or a thing, that is used in making different objects is called a material. So there are the so many different objects are there, and different objects are made up of different substances, and that substances is called as what? Material. So there are the so many objects are present around us, and each and every object is made up of different substance. So the substance which we use to make a different object, that substance or a thing is called as what? Material. And very important sentence is that each and every, all the objects are made up of material. All the objects are made up of material. It will be different according to the objects, the material can get changed. So now here see, I'm having this scale. So this scale is made up of wood. So the wood is material from which this scale is made. Next one we can say that this is the duster. Okay, so this duster is made from the plastic. So the plastic is the material from which this duster is get made. Next one I can show you, this is the glass beaker. Okay, this is the glass beaker. So what is the material in this? Yes, you are correct. So the glass is the material from which this beaker is made. Next one is that this is the spatula. Okay, this is the spatula. The spatula is made up of steel. So in this, what is the material? Steel is the material from which this glass spatula is get made. So in this way, there are so many different materials are present around us. We can say that copper, iron, cotton, silk or plastic. All these are the different materials. From that different materials, we are making the different objects. So mainly the materials are divided into two groups, that are natural and human made. So from the name only we can say that the materials which are naturally present, that materials are called as natural material, while the material which made by human being or in the factories, that material is called as what? Human made material. So there are the two types of the material, natural which get naturally or which is present naturally, and next one is human made, which is made by the human in the factories. It is called as what? Human made material. So here I am having this scale. So this scale is made up of wood, and wood is what? Natural material. Why? Because the wood we are getting from plants. Okay, if we can say that cotton clothes. So the cotton is what? Through a plant product. Okay, that is what? Cotton is a natural material. But if we can say that this is the duster which is made from this plastic. So this plastic is what? Man-made. Okay, so the plastic is a man-made material. Why? Because plastics we are making in the factories, and that is the reason plastic is what? Man-made material. So in this way, these are the two types of the material, natural material and human made material. So this is about material. Let's move for the next point, that we can say that an object's made up of different material. Okay, so we can say that one object is made from the different material. So every day we are having the lunch, breakfast, dinner. For that we are using the plate. So the plates are of a different material. We can see the steel plate also. We can see the plastic plate. We can see the iron plate. We can see the copper plate. So in this way, glass plate is also there. So in this way, according to our convenience, we are using the different materials for all the different material plates for our daily use. So from this, what we can say that one object. What is the object? Plate is the object.
But to make that plate, we are using the different material. So here what we can say that an object made of different material. So with the help of object is only one, but to make that object, so we are using the different material. We can make the plate from glass also. We can make the plate from plastic also. We can make the plate from steel also. We can make the plate from copper also, from iron also, and from aluminium also. Okay. So the material we can use different to make a plate. So the one objects can be made with the help of the different material. Okay. Here we can say that. Next one we can say that. Different for this one activity is given in your textbook, that is activity number 2 that you have to complete. Certain objects are given, for that objects which material we are using, that you have to write in that box. Okay, so you have to complete this activity. 1 has done for you. We can say that chair we can made from the plastic also, wood also. Okay, so if we can say that clothes, for the clothes we can use the cotton, we can use the silk, we can use the nylon. Okay, leather also we can use sometime to make a cloth. So in this way, different objects we can make from the different material. The same objects we can make from the different material. So here you have to complete the activity number 2 from page number 30. Next one point we will discuss, that is different types of objects made from same material. Very important. Now objects are different, but it is made from same material. Okay. So see here. Here I am having this duster. Here I am having this marker. Okay. So this duster is also made up of plastic. This marker is also made up of plastic. Okay, so the material is what? Same, but the objects are different. So what we can say that different types of object made from same material. So the same materials are there, but the objects are different. So the different objects can be made from same material. Okay, here we can say that what? Different types of objects made from the same material. See, this is marker, this is duster, and also we can say this is one beaker, which is also made up of plastic. So the objects are different, but the one similarity between all these objects is what? All these objects are made up of same material, that is nothing but what? Plastic. Okay, for this purpose also, for this point also, one activity is given, that is what? Activity number 3, that also you have to complete in your textbook. Now we'll move for the next one, that is an object made up of combination of material. Now combination of material means what? One objects or the one substance can be made by using the different objects. For example, we can say the biscuit that we are having every day. So have you think ever how these biscuits are made? To make the biscuits, we are using the flour or all purpose flour, that is we are calling commonly as a maida. For that we are using the sugar, we are using the ghee, all these things we are using to make a biscuits. With the help of that ghee, maida and sugar, sometime we are adding the milk also. So all these things, all these substances we are using to make only one object, that is nothing but what? Biscuit. So from different material only one object is made, that is what? Biscuits. From maida, all purpose flour, from sugar, from milk, from ghee, from these four material we have made only one object, that is what? Biscuit. So from this, what we can say? With the help of the combination of the material we can make a object. So the objects can be made up of combination of material. Also we can say that vegetable curry, if you want to prepare, then so many things we are adding in that. We want to make the dal also. Generally we are having in our house dal and rice. To make that dal also, we are using the different substance. We are using oil, we are using curry leaves, mustard, turmeric, salt, pulses, all these things we combine and then we can make the one object, that is nothing but what? Our dal. So to make one object, we can use the combination of the material and then we can make an object. So for this also we are having the activity, that is activity number 4, that also you have to complete in your textbook. Okay, So from all this discussion, what we have concluded, that is an object is made up of different materials. Next one, different types of objects made from same material. And the third one is what? An object made up of a combination of material. Beside the which type of the material is used to make a object, we should do the study of the properties of that material. This way, if you do the study of the properties of different materials, so from that we can come to know which type of the material is used to make any particular object. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the materials, and today we have discussed about these some factors about an object. Okay, so this is all about today. Here we will stop, but we will meet in the next video with the next point. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.